In the back of the book segment tonight, the Factor prides itself on fighting the good fight when it comes to the culture war. We often cover stories that you will not hear about in the mainstream media. Helping us with that is Fox News Radio host Todd Starnes. He's the author of the new book, Godless America, Real Stories from the Front Lines on the Attack on Traditional Values. He joins us now from New York. And Todd, it's great to see you. Man, I can tell you from my own radio listeners, people really do feel like, you know, Christians, and sort of, especially Christian conservatives, that's the last bastion that you can really attack with impunity, that you can discriminate against with impunity, that, you know, they're looked at as uncool and, mm-hmm. and not up to date, right. And, you know, they're a bunch of troglodytes. And you found that this, in fact, is kind of being borne out, both in the military context and the public school context. Let's start with the military.
Well, Laura, what's happening in the military is very disturbing. Under this president, over the past 5 years, I have documented a number of instances where Christianity has come under attack. And quite frankly, I've had officers, high-ranking officers in the military, say they've been told to hide their faith. It was just last year that I reported, and I write about this in the book, that soldiers were given training sessions and seminars where they were told that evangelical Christianity and Roman Catholicism were examples of religious extremism, that groups like the Family Research Council and American Family Association were domestic hate groups. And they went so far as to tell other officers in one unit that they should be on the lookout for soldiers that might be giving money or getting materials from these organizations. This is what's happening here in President Obama's military.
Todd, first of all, that's a scandal, right? Can you imagine if a military officer were telling a soldier or a Marine, you can't give money to GLAAD, or GLAAD is a group that's suspicious or has views that are controversial? Can you imagine what would be done to that high-ranking military official? He would be drummed out. His stuff would be packed, and it'd be on the next plane out.
And let me take it a step further. I tell the story in the book of one individual at Lackland Air Force Base who was called in by his lesbian commander and was ordered to disclose his personal held position on gay marriage. And when he refused to do so, he had to suffer the consequences of that. So there is an all-out assault in the military. And here's the reason why. I believe that under this president, they have turned the military into a social engineering petri dish. And if they're able to implement this attack on Christianity, and let's be very clear, it's a war on religious liberty, but they're coming after Christians. If they're able to come after Christians in the military, they're certainly going to be able to do that in the general population.
And they're doing it in the public schools. Very briefly, Todd, give us a highlight.
Well, they certainly are, Laura. Look, I grew up in the South, and my book is really flavored with Southern sensibilities. And to be perfectly honest, these days, I sort of feel like a Duck Dynasty guy living in a Miley Cyrus world. You know, right is wrong, wrong is right, and folks are just genuinely confused. And I think in our public school system especially, we have seen young Christian students come under fierce attack. One that I write about, a guy by the name of Roy Costner, who actually had his graduation speech censored by his school.
And Todd, your book is terrific, a must read. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
On Deck, former